6 months ago, my dad asked me before he passed to make sure to get the house ready for sale, sell it, and just make sure that my mom is taken care of. So it took a couple months to find a place for my mom, and then it's been took another few months, probably 3 months, for her to start settling in. And so this is where we're at. If you want to see the rest of the playlist for how we've decluttered or how to downsize after a loss, please check out that playlist. So now we're here in our kitchen nook. And one thing as far as decluttering or downsizing, you really want to think about one section at a time. Instead of I'm going to declutter the whole house, that's overwhelming, just think of specific spaces. And even within that space, like the kitchen, break it down into sections. Because how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. So how do you declutter our house? One section at a time. So you can see from my playlist that even for the kitchen, we have done, let's say, the kitchen cabinets and the fridge, the kitchen island, the pantry, and now here in the kitchen nook. So I'm looking at this space. A lot of it is, you know, kind of like that desk that you have in certain homes where the idea, I suppose, of the builders or whoever designed the house is that to have a little desk area in the kitchen, because this is the heart of the home. And while people are here eating, cooking, whatever, you could take care of, let's say, bills or homework or take care of kids' papers here. But one of the things that it does is that it is a magnet for clutter. And so you might have an office space and then there's more office supplies here. So as I'm looking at this, I know that my home office, I have all the supplies that I need, so I'm most likely not going to keep anything. Last time I did keep something which from another room, which was a little paperweight that my dad had since I was a kid. So that's one of the things I'm keeping. It's not a big piece of furniture, it's not a bunch of tchotchkes, but it's something meaningful, it's small, and it's actually a paperweight that I've been wanting to get one. So that works out. So you just want to make sure as you're going through downsizing or decluttering, there's a lot of decisions that you have to make, and you can face decision fatigue. And once you get to a certain point, then you pause and start over again. So that's what we've been doing. We've just been taking a few hours every couple weeks to get through these things. And of course I'm filming, so that takes extra time, but you are going to get through it. And I just wanted to make this series just so you know that other people are going through the same thing you're going through, maybe have different nuances and different challenges, but we all face that challenge of running into sentimental items and having to make a decision or choice about that. And a lot of times it could be, you know what, not right now. And that's one of the reasons we even got a storage unit. So you can watch that video there too. All right, my mic has no battery right now, so I'm just gonna talk. So what I'm gonna do is, even within this section, I'm gonna go by section. So the top part, then we're gonna do that drawer and cabinets, the middle part, including underneath, and then here on the right. So you could go left to right, top to bottom, clockwise, counterclockwise, however you wanna do it. Just have a path, because then you're gonna see, oh, this part is done. As you keep moving forward, it helps you feel like you've achieved something. Okay, so I know that we are not gonna keep the fax machine, nor the telephone, and then we're just gonna go through stuff and make quick decisions. And then as far as cleaning anything, we're not going to, because once everything's cleared out, we're gonna have the cleaners come and deep clean everything. But before that, the handyman to come fix any holes. We're not sure if we're gonna paint. Our realtor said we may not have to. And then the cleaners will come. Okay, the top cleared out, that was like 5 minutes. And my daughter's actually here helping me. So I'm giving her the stuff. I'm saying trash, donate Goodwill, or we are keeping. So she's making piles for that behind me. And my husband is in the garage. We have a pile of stuff to bring home. He's going through that again, making sure it's stuff that we need or want. Okay, so for the keys, I'm just gonna put them in a Ziploc, or if we can find a bag here and bring that, because I have a box in my closet where I'm keeping all kind of like valuable stuff, so we don't want to throw any keys yet, just to make sure. Although I have all the keys for the house, I just want to make sure. Okay, just a little update. Well, we're almost done with this. You can see that stuff like the fax machine, we can went ahead and give to Goodwill. All the chemicals that were under here, if there's some stuff for like the pool, we're keeping that, but the other stuff we're setting aside in a different pile, and then that's where we'll have to get rid of those things responsibly. And so your city might have a chemical waste, I forgot what it's, or hazardous waste materials pickup. Yeah, you can ask them to pick up straight from your house, or they might have a time for the whole city, and it's usually a couple times a year or something like that. Like in electronics, they do that too. And so that's where we're at, and we've just got a drawer and a cabinet left. Okay, friends, I feel good. That only took 30 minutes, and you can see because a lot of it was just trash. And the chemical waste, like I said, just gotta get rid of, dispose of those things responsibly. And I just knew that we already had a lot of office supplies. And then things like the keys we put away, keeping those in a safe place until we know we don't really need it. And of course, we don't need a fax machine. Alright friends, click the next video to see the playlist for my whole downsizing, decluttering after a loss, and maybe it will give you some ideas on how to take care of your downsizing or decluttering, or if you just want to declutter because you need more breathing space. Alright, see you in the next one.